Finally, a geeky science for the day, and then I'll pick up your phone calls. This is an amazing study. This was a study that was done on 84,709 postmenopausal women in the United States. It's a study that took 19 years. And what they found was that the women who ate almost an ounce of chocolate a day had the lowest risk of dying young. It's 28 grams of chocolate. It's like, you know, a chocolate bar once a day. Now, the downside, of course, is if you're eating chocolate that's got a lot of sugar in it, you're going to ruin your teeth, and that's not good for your body, and it can screw with your metabolism. But they do sell, like, you know, this 90% chocolate and the 80%. I actually love those chocolates. I love the 90%. Louise can't even eat the 90%. So I buy the 70%. And she can sort of eat that. She's more into milk chocolate, but this is amazing. Chocolate eaters were less likely to die of heart disease and some cancers compared with people who never indulge. And the reason why, they're pretty sure cocoa is known to lower blood pressure. It's known to stop the fat buildup in your arteries. And again, look at the chocolate bar. If it says made with milk fat, you don't want that, because milk fat actually does, you know, I mean, dairy products contribute to heart disease, right? But if it's made with cocoa butter, then apparently that's good for you, at least according to this study. So be sure you get the right kind of chocolate if you're going to go on the chocolate diet, right? It seems like you want to do it right. You want to do it with the proper stuff. And, you know, ideally also buy it from a company that's selling chocolate that's produced without child or slave labor, because there are, you know, some aspects of the chocolate business are really pretty nasty. And that, in my opinion, that means staying away from the big brands. But, you know, it's up to you. Anyhow, FYI, we'll be right back with your call. Stay tuned.